the zebra. The tiger found the zebra and invited it to dine. He said, "If you could join me, that would simply be divine." The zebra said, "I thank you, but respectfully decline. I heard you were the antelope. He was a friend of mine." On hearing this, the tiger cried, "I must admit, it's true. I also ate the buffalo, the llama, and the gnu. And yes, I ate the warthog, the gazelle, and kangaroo. But I could never eat a creature beautiful as you. You see, I have a secret. I am embarrassed to confide. I look on you with envy and a modicum of pride. Of all the creatures ever known," the tiger gently sighed, "it seems we are the only two with such a stripy hide. Now seeing how we share this strong resemblance of the skin, I only can conclude that we are just as close as kin. This means you are my brother, and though fearsome I've been, I could not eat my brother. That would surely be a sin." The zebra thought and then replied, "I'm certain you are right. The stripy coats we both possess are such a handsome sight. My brother, will you let me reconsider if I might? My calendar is empty, so please let us dine till night." The tiger met the zebra in his brand new fancy car and drove him to a restaurant which wasn't very far. And when they both were seated at a table near the bar, the zebra asked, "What's on the grill?" The tiger said, "You are..." "But please, you cannot dine on me," the outraged zebra cried. "You took me up and eat me, the thing I can't abide. You asked me for your trust, and I unwillingly complied. You said you could not eat me, and now you plan to have me fried? And what about the envy and the modicum of pride? And what of us as brothers, since we share a stripy hide?" "I'm sorry," said the tiger, and he smiled as he replied, "but I love the taste of zebra, so in other words, I like. Thank you."